So Tony, you experienced the glorious dot-com era in the 90s with Red Herring. What are your feelings and thoughts about it right now?
Well, I think, you know, it's interesting to know, but at the top of the internet bubble, there were only 165 million people on the internet. Now there's 2 billion. So even though I wrote the book, The Internet Bubble in 99, and told everybody to sell their internet stocks, part of the message of that book was that the best time to be an entrepreneur would be right now. And so I think it's a very exciting time, and it's the most fun I've ever had in my career.
And where do you see the next dot-com coming from?
Well, I think there's some mega trends. Certainly the mobile, the smartphone explosion, the movement of data to the cloud, social media in general, the socialization really of everything on the internet, including commerce, entertainment, and media. I think these all represent really huge growth opportunities, really huge opportunities for new startups, and I think that whole opportunity is going to extend far off into the future. So I think we're sitting at the very beginning of really a 20-year run of an opportunity to build great internet companies.
And outside the virtual world, what do you think about ISPBC's Building 2.0? Do you think that could become the real dot-com outside internet, because it's based on real money, not virtual money, and it's based on the biggest economy in the world, the real estate business?
I do. I think that, you know, we tend to forget about the physical world when we talk about the internet, but it's really the combination of both the physical and the virtual that is the most powerful opportunity. So it's just a matter of integrating the two, and I think you all are doing a great job in that area, and it's, you know, a great foundation to create a lot of revenue and employment growth and, you know, a good stable future.